Shock report: Texas shooter was SJW atheist. Liberals celebrate mass deaths. It's sick. Rumors are swirling across the internet about Devin Patrick Kelly, the gunman who slaughtered 26 people in a Texas church and left 30 more wounded before he was stopped. Some sources are claiming that he was an Antifa member who vowed to wage a communist revolution. These reports are still in hot dispute. Who was Devin Patrick Kelly? Gathered from his various social media accounts, Kelly was an ex-Christian who apparently turned atheist. According to the shooter's LinkedIn page, issues he was concerned with include animal welfare, arts and culture, children, civil rights and social action, environment, health, and, here's the kicker, human rights. While a couple of LinkedIn posts might not be the best way to judge one's political background, it's not hard to see this guy is probably on the left wing. And it definitely flies in the face of what the left so badly wanted. This gunman was not another Dylan Roof driven by racism. The victims were white conservatives in the heart of rural Texas, and, just like the Las Vegas shooting, most likely Trump supporters. According to the Daily Mail, Kelly's former classmates reported him as being creepy, crazy and weird. The shooter was an outcast who preached atheism online before carrying out the worst mass shooting on a church. He was always talking about how people who believe in God we are stupid and trying to preach his atheism, former classmate Nina Rosnava posted to her Facebook, further stating that she was in complete shock that he committed this massacre and deleted his Facebook account from her friends list. This doesn't mean that atheists are to blame, but it's overwhelmingly obvious, despite CNN's clueless insistence that the motives of the shooter are mystery, that this was at least partly an anti-Christian hate crime. Yes, liberals, that also means that, despite his skin color not being black or brown, this was an act of terrorism. But what's even more disgusting, were the left-wing trolls who berated and even celebrated the slaughter of white conservative Christians. Predictably, liberal celebrities and politicians have taken to their Twitters to instantly call for more gun control. Little do they realize, the killer was dishonorably kicked out of the military. He was already barred by law from purchasing or possessing any firearms. Gun laws did diddly squat here. Here's another fact to make liberals scream. Sure enough, the gunman who shot up a gun-free zone church with an illegally obtained firearm was stopped by another resident with a firearm. If there's any good to be gleaned from this tragedy, it's that this is a textbook case of how gun control laws do not work and could have killed countless more people. Was this man an Antifa soldier? Was this the November 4th communist revolution that came a day late? There is no doubt about one thing, this was a hate crime meant to target Christians and conservatives. The media needs to come out and say the truth about all this violence. This year of shootings and attempted political assassinations has proven that patriots are under attack and being targeted for mass extermination.